Hey everyone, welcome back to another video in which we will be aiming to help the community as a whole. Because if you haven't been paying attention, then the Inside Vault article yesterday has come out and it detailed how the fortifying Atlas Observatory is gonna be an event that we need to look forward to, as it's gonna not only reward the community as a whole with certain items like Brother of Steel Berry, a Camp Banner, sort of event weeks like double daily challenges and whatnot, but to do this, you of course need to donate as a whole, so as a community, certain junk items during a period of time, which is actually going to be about 3 or 4 days each time, which is, you know, not much, but this is why this video is here. So, the first four items that you will need on the list, these are going to be all having their own respective 4 days or three to donate. This is going to be steel, the first one, then concrete, then cork, then plastic. This is the first half, which is the first four. Then the second half, which is the second four, is the wood, cloth, leather and glass. Now, while I could go over to where to find wood, you know, wood is pretty much just the easiest to collect in the forest region with just, you know, clicking on with the woodchucker perk equipped on all the wood that's littered about. Cloth is pretty much just scrapping down armor, so is leather. But cloth can be also earned from scrapping pre-war money, which you can usually find in safes. In bulks, usually you find like more than 10 or even 20 sometimes. And glass is again something that you don't even use much, so it's usually just sort of adds up over time, even if you don't really look for it. So I'm pretty sure that glass isn't going to be an issue either. But going back to the first four items, the steel, concrete, cork and plastic, these are much rarer and much more sought after. And if you look at the amounts required, it's actually not that much less than the other items that are supposedly much more frequent. So, in this video I'm going to be trying to show where you can get some of these. So, let's start off with steel, shall we? No, actually no, we are starting out with concrete, because concrete is probably the least known from these. We are down here at the abandoned Bogtown. I first leveled in with the pylon V13, which is over there. And once you run out of here, or run up here, then you're gonna be seeing either from this entrance with this scaffolding up here, or the other entrance, which is over there with the sort of fire exit, I guess, as you can see down here. If you go inside, then there's going to be a bunch of concrete or sort of cement bags. First of all, there is like four here. Then there is a fifth over here. A sixth on top of this sort of foundation. So that's six so far. Then you have got another 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And I already picked one up, but there was one here as well. So that's 13. And you know, keep in mind that each of these bags will give you 7 concrete. So 13 times 7, that's a quick math, it's gonna be 91 concrete for each of these runs. Of course, these replenish every 24 hours, so if you pick it up, then you either need to switch characters, which actually works for this one, because you know, you can donate with separate characters to the same overall goal. But if you don't wanna, if you don't have more characters, or you just don't wanna switch characters, then just wait 24 hours and you can do it again. You know, they told us in advance what they'll require from us, so there is no reason not to start collecting right now. Especially for those with Fallout first who can literally store infinite junk, shouldn't have an issue with getting some of these items gathered up. But for now, let's move on to the next items, which is gonna be steel. Basically, I probably won't need to go there because there is, of course, a workshop called Grafton Steel. It's famous for having built up the steel collectors. Even if you get there, you don't actually need to build them up yourself. You just need to power them up. And the other thing is that it's infested by a bunch of supermutants. And supermutants usually drop weapons that contain a lot of steel. Now, in this case, and this is actually true for every single scorch and supermutant that drop weapons and you can scrap for steel, instead of telling you which locations you can go to farm steel, I'm going to tell you which perks to choose for this. So if you don't have it already, I'm talking about the scrapper perk, which is gonna make you get more components when you scrap weapons and armor. And just to showcase that sort of ratio of, you know, how much you scrap with and without it, right now I got here a sharpshooter's assault rifle, right? If I scrap it, it's gonna give me 1 rubber and 7 steel. Now, if you put in something like, of course, the scrapper perk, guess how many it will yield you? You guessed it right, or probably wrong, because it's actually gonna give you 20 steel. It's more than double the amount you would usually get. Sadly, the rubber is not increased, but the steel itself is just in itself worth it. So with this, if you go through something like Vestek, for example, and just collect all of the assault rifles from the supermutants, you can get a shit ton of steel for your name, and quite easily as well. And of course, since these recharge, you know, because enemies respawn every time you hop into a new server, you can actually farm these without any limitation whatsoever, unlike, for example, something like concrete, which is not dropped by enemies, sadly. Alright, so we are down here at the White Springs, and no, not the White Springs Golf Club specifically, but the entire White Springs, because White Springs is probably the location that is littered about with golf balls the most. And you can see that, for example, in this car there is a bunch of golf balls littered around on there. I already picked up a few from this basket. There is a few, of course, in the golf club as well, because why wouldn't there be? But if you just, you know, go through this path walk all the way through the White Springs houses, so to speak, or the White Springs golf fields, there's gonna be a bunch of golf balls, and the reason why you need them is because the golf balls contain both cork and the plastic, which means that both of the challenges that's gonna be coming, you know, one of them is cork, one of them is plastic, you're gonna get one step closer to those each. And, you know, I mean, one is might not sound too much, but since golf balls actually have an abundance of spawn, and they also spawn in these, you know, golf bags right here, and not just here, of course, any golf bags they can spawn with a golf ball or more. For this reason, it's actually pretty easy to farm them. So hopefully by the time the actual challenge runs around, it's the third and fourth that we are looking at right now, we're actually gonna be having quite a bit of cork and plastic to our name. So, I know it's a bit of a shorter video, but hopefully it will help you a bit to inch closer towards that final goal that we need to reach as a community. So I'll see you guys there, and hopefully we'll be able to get ourselves some nice rewards. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.